Thank you, Madam Speaker, and through you to the members. Madam Speaker, I am delighted that we are taking up H4791, an act relative to municipal tax lien procedures and protections for property owners in the Commonwealth. Thank you to the gentleperson from Franklin for partnering with me on this legislation. When he discovered we were independently considering filing this bill, he telephoned to encourage me to partner with him. As I had neither experience nor charm to offer, I'm especially grateful for his graciousness and mentorship. Thank you to the gentleperson from the Salisbury Street neighborhood of Worcester, the gentleperson from Andover, the senator from Hampshire, Franklin, and Worcester, and the senator from the 2nd Bristol and Plymouth districts for their work on this topic as well, and for the many colleagues who offered encouragement and anecdotes. Thank you to the speaker and the gentlepersons from the North End and Braintree for your leadership and guidance on this important issue and so many others. And thank you to the Joint Committee on Revenue staff for working closely with staff from Franklin and Brookline in refining and improving this bill. Finally, I want to thank my colleagues for joining me today on what is now my second favorite June 26th, falling well short of my wedding day 20 years ago. I first read about this issue several years ago in a piece highlighting the muchachos of Easton who lost 100% of the equity of their $250,000 home to cover a $30,000 municipal back tax assessment. Several years later, New Bedford resident Deborah Foss owed the city $10,000 and ultimately lost over $200,000 in additional equity, her equity, to an unethical practice enabled by a law I hope we vote to change today. These are two examples of the many horror stories that inspired the gentleperson from Franklin and me to work on this issue. In Massachusetts, when a taxpayer fails to pay municipal taxes, fines, or fees, the municipality has several options available to collect. For instance, a lawsuit can be filed on the debt, a lien could be placed on the property, or a taking can occur. But often, a tax deed is executed. Under MGL Chapter 60, Sections 53 and 54, within 14 days of a demand for unpaid taxes, a tax collector can execute a tax deed and record the deed on the land. The tax deed is not a lien, but rather gives the municipality immediate possession of the property with the right of redemption for the taxpayer until foreclosure is complete. Upon foreclosure without redemption, the municipality's property rights are absolute and without recourse. Madam Speaker, the matter before us is one of simple fairness. Residents of our Commonwealth ought to pay municipalities what they owe, no less and certainly no more. Should other remedies be exhausted or inappropriate and the municipality proceed with legal action to recover the money owed, that municipality, like all other creditors, must be limited in retaining only the debt that is owed, returning the remaining proceeds to the debtor. The gentleman from Braintree did an excellent job describing this bill, allowing me to simply conclude, Madam Speaker, I hope that my wife will join me for dinner tonight, and I hope that our colleagues will merely join me in voting in favor of this bill. Thank you.